GeoStudio 2016 has just been released. This release builds upon the updates and releases from 2015 and includes several additional or updated features improving the functionality of all GeoStudio products. This video will summarize and demonstrate these features. GeoStudio 2016 includes a new viewing capability referred to as Page Layout, which is available in all of the GeoStudio products. Both the Define and Results views can be displayed in Page Layout for improved presentation and printing of GeoStudio models and results. Page Layout includes additional sketching features which can be used to create a printing template. In a GeoStudio analysis, the new Page Layout option appears in the top toolbar. This icon allows you to toggle the Page Layout layer on or off in either the Define or the Results views. In Page Layout, I can specify page size and orientation, and I can use the Modify Objects function to change the size of the viewport where the model appears. I can use the Fit to Viewport button so that my model nicely fits within the specified area. I can use the Sketch features to generate a printing template, or I can click on the Import Layout button to open a previously generated template file. Given the addition of Page Layout View, the original model space was updated for GeoStudio 2016. Model View is no longer based on a specified page. Instead, an infinite model space is available for the Define and Results views, with an updated grid and reference lines through the origin to assist with visualization. The zoom features have also been modified for the infinite model space. In a GeoStudio analysis, you can see that the original model page no longer exists and that red and green reference lines run through the origin. The snap to grid lines feature can be toggled off or on, and the grid spacing can be specified in the bottom status toolbar. The coordinate prompt can be used to center the view on the specified point, and the Zoom Objects icon can be used to zoom to your model domain. The Pan function can also be selected by clicking on the hand symbol in the status toolbar. Finally, under Set, Units, and Scale, the Reference Scale, which is the scale used to render font, can be adjusted and a vertical exaggeration may be specified. Material properties and boundary conditions can now be assigned to multiple analyses at once, including the application of beams or bars in Sigma W. In GeoStudio, when you go to Draw Materials or Draw Boundary Conditions, the Apply to Multiple Analyses option appears at the bottom of the window. When this option is selected, a drop-down window appears, allowing for the quick selection of multiple analyses from the project file. When you assign or remove a boundary condition or a material property to multiple analyses, the status beside each of the selected analyses includes the success or failure of your action. The status will also provide a brief explanation of why an action was not successful. Properties of a slope W analysis can now be applied to others in the same project file. Properties such as slip surface entry and exit points, pore water pressures, or point loads specified in one analysis can be quickly and easily transferred to other analyses. In GeoStudio 2016, the new Replace and Analysis feature can be found under the Key In tab. The Replace and Analysis window includes a list of properties which can be applied to other slope W analyses in the project file. The replacement status is provided in the right column after selecting a property and applying it to another analysis. The new Modify Sketch Properties command can be used to alter the properties of objects after they have been drawn, including text, lines, dimensions, circles, arcs, pictures, and axes. This feature also allows users to specify whether the selected object should only be displayed in the current analysis. The Modify Sketch Properties function is under the Modify tab in both Model Space and Page Layout View. When I select an object, the Modify Sketch window appears. In this window, I can specify whether I'd like the sketch to only appear in the current analysis and modify its properties. The material property tables have improved formatting. As you can see here, the tables now include colors and borders and have better column alignment. Improved printing capabilities now allow you to print directly from page layout and print multiple analyses at once using the Select Analyses to Print button. In addition to English, French, Spanish, and Chinese, GeoStudio is now available in Portuguese. In summary, GeoStudio 2016 offers a new page layout layer for improved presentation of models and results, and an updated model space with infinite extents and enhanced zooming and viewing capabilities. Additional assignment features for material properties, boundary conditions, and slope W properties are now available. The materials table has an updated format, the sketch functions have been improved, and users may now print multiple analyses at once. Finally, GeoStudio is now available in Portuguese. This video includes all of the updated features in GeoStudio 2016. However, there have been many additional changes to the GeoStudio products in recent releases of the software. Please take a look at the What's New page of the GeoSLOPE website and tutorial videos for the previous releases for more information. Thank you for watching.